I've mostly switched over to digital FPV on all of my quads. I have missed flying my Babytooth, since that is one of the quads that is still on analog, because even a naked Vista would be too heavy for 1S. I got the Goggles 3 earlier this year, and perhaps the DJI O4 Air Unit with its weight of just 9 grams can change this. Let's see if we can build a digital Babytooth.
I already got a Babytooth 1.5mm frame years ago, and since I have the 1202.5 FPV cycle motors on the analog Babytooth, I chose to go with the same size Flywoo Robo 1202.5 motors for this build. On to the flight controller. I chose the BetaFPV Matrix 1S, since it has an integrated 5V BEC that can power the O4. You can technically run the O4 directly on 1S, but it is only rated for 3.7 volts, so it will brown out and lose picture on punchouts when the voltage drops. The Matrix 1S also has integrated Express LRS, so no need for a separate receiver. It also has 16 megs of black box, and it weighs just 3.8 grams.
The issue is that the board is tiny, so removing the motor plugs can be a bit tricky. The motor pads on the other side are a bit bigger, but still really small, so you need to have a steady hand. And a quick picture of my workbench. The wife is not too happy. Fortunately, she was not home to see all of the clutter. On to the O4 Air Unit. Small, light, but it has one issue. The field of view is really narrow, at only 117 degrees. Fortunately, it is possible to modify the camera by swapping to a different lens. The original lens can be removed by using hot air and some pliers. I managed to get the lens off, but I also managed to damage the camera connector in the process. I really should have removed the camera cable before I started twisting the lens with the pliers. Many have suggested to use the Caddx Ant camera housing and lens, so I did just that and secured it with some B7000 glue. Here is a quick side-by-side comparison between the original lens and the Caddx Ant lens. The camera still works, but I'm getting the IMU error, so the broken pins in the connector are for the gyro, so no stabilization. I opted to mount the O4 on the bottom and the flight controller upside down on top of it, with the connector for the USB facing forward. It is pretty straightforward to remap the motors and rotate the board in Betaflight configurator these days. The digital Babytooth is, amazingly enough, almost the same weight as the analog one, only 0.2 grams difference. This is partly due to the frame, since I used the 1.5mm for the digital build, and the analog has a heavier 2.3mm one. On the other hand, the Matrix 1S is lighter than the Happy Model board on the analog build, and having an integrated receiver saves at least a few grams.
Time to test it. Crap.
I seem to have an issue with one of the ESCs for the front right motor. I had an extra motor, so I swapped that in and verified that the issue is not the motor, so it has to be the ESC. In any case, I have to order a replacement board.
With the replacement flight controller in hand, let's test it first this time. I hooked it up to the motors of my old Isshin UK65, and all motors worked perfectly. So far, so good. Now I have to remove the motor plugs and solder all the motors again. Finally, all done. I got some LiHV 450mAh high-volt batteries with the BT2.0 connector, since the BetaFPV flight controller naturally came with this connector. I also got some spare connectors and converted the analog Babytooth and some old 450mAh batteries from PH2 to BT2.0. Not as good as an XT30, but clearly better for the voltage sag. I also replaced the stack screws for a couple of shorter ones to save about 0.4 grams. Ended up at 57.2 grams all up weight. It would be possible to save another half a gram or so by changing to a lighter canopy, but I prefer to have a bit more protection for the O4 camera, knowing how fragile the connector is.
Let's flight test this thing now then.
This on stock Betaflight PIDs, Express LRS 250Hz preset, RPM filtering, 48kHz PWM.
Quite a lot of vibrations on both roll and pitch. A bit more on pitch, I'd say.
The gyroscaled plot looks as one can expect, and while the filtered gyro plot looks decent on first glance, the noise really gets amplified into the D term, and there is way too much noise from 90 to 300 Hz, with the biggest issue being in the 120 to 150 Hz area. The PIDs look okay otherwise, no big overshoots nor bounce backs, so the PIDs will not need a lot of adjustments. Let's focus on the filters.
The first thing is to upgrade the ESCs to the newest release candidate version of the Bluejay firmware, and at the same time change to 24 kHz PWM frequency instead of 48 kHz. 24 kHz will give a little bit more power and make the quad less floaty, at the expense of some flight time. I added more filtering by bringing the gyro filter multiplier slider down to somewhere around 0.5 and 0.6, while keeping the D term between 0.9 and 1.1. This adds more filtering to the lower gyro frequencies, where the RPM filtering is already taking care of the higher frequencies. Very minor changes here. I brought the D gains and the master multiplier down a bit, while adding a bit feed forward for better stick response. These changes improved the situation quite a bit. It is still not perfect, but I can continue to refine this in the future, since the flight controller has memory for black box logging.
Also, the O4 Air Unit Pro has really good low-light performance. The non-Pro Air Unit is not as good, but works well enough in the dark. Let's fly the analog and the digital Babytooth back-to-back and compare. They do feel a bit different. The analog feels more smooth, but also less precise.
This may, of course, be due to the flight controllers running very different versions of Betaflight, and the fact that I'm running Express LRS at 250 Hz and using feed-forward on the digital build. The digital also, of course, beats the analog hands down in terms of range and picture quality, and having the onboard 4K recording is an added bonus. Just need to get the camera repaired in order to be able to use Gyroflow to stabilize the footage without having to mess with any black box logs for gyro data. One clear advantage of the analog build is the flight time. I can get about 6 minutes from the analog Babytooth, while the digital one will give me 4.5 minutes using the exact same battery. The digital version clearly draws more amps. One difference is, of course, the O4 Air unit. It draws over 1 amp by itself. 1.2 amps at 700 milliwatts, according to DJI. The amp draw when cruising around also shows this, since the analog version consumes less than 5 amps, while the digital uses 6.5 when just cruising around. Both have the same exact Gemfan props, so perhaps the FPV cycle motors are just a tad more efficient? The difference is, however, very small.
Getting back to the broken camera connector. Flywoo actually sells a replacement camera for the O4 Air unit, so I picked one up. Looks very similar to the original, but there are some minor differences on the circuit board, at least as seen here. So let's try the lens mod again, but without having the cable connected this time. Easy peasy with just some hot air. I happen to have an old analog Foxeer Pico camera that I never got around using, so I thought I'd test it since I did not have another Ant camera available. Unfortunately, I went a bit too far when applying the heat and ended up melting the plastic housing, so I had to find something else. Found a mini camera branded camera in my stash of old gear and chose to not apply any excess heat this time. And as before, used B7000 glue to attach the housing to the sensor. I was unfortunately not able to adjust the lens from the mini camera to get anything in focus, so I instead took the 1.8mm lens of a Caddx Baby Retel camera, since the Retel cameras have really good image quality due to having a large sensor, just like the O4 Air unit does. The plastic housing does not weigh much, but the glass Retel lens is 1.5 grams more than the original O4 plastic lens, so the overall weight has increased by that amount. Here is a comparison between the original lens and the Baby Retel lens. And a comparison between the Ant and the Baby Retel. The Baby Retel has a slightly larger field of view and more distortion than the Ant, even if both cameras state 165 degrees. Both are good, but I'll continue using the Ant on the digital Babytooth for now.
There you have it, folks.
Thanks to the O4 Air unit, it is finally possible for DJI pilots to join the HD0 and Walksnail gang and go digital on their Babytooths. What do you think I should do next? Further try to shave off a few grams from the digital Babytooth? Or add a mini GPS to it to see how fast it can go? Or perhaps I should go digital on the TP3 as well? Tell me down below in the comments.